Hello, this is Marianne Kresman, and I'm sitting here with two folks who live at the Livestock Exchange Building, our historic Livestock Exchange Building in Omaha, Nebraska. And they are residents of this building because the fourth through the ninth floor have apartments. And so I'm with Francisco Acosta and his wife, Peggy Acosta. And this is September 5th, Labor Day, 2011. So welcome, Francisco and Peggy. Thank you for spending time here with us today. So I am eager to know from you about your living here and exercise. We know that outdoor exercise is very important for people. And Francesco, you have diabetes, so it's very important that you get exercise in particular, as well as yourself, Peggy. So what is there available for you in terms of outdoor exercise?
The exercise, they have a room, you know, they have exercise, but it's for like, and
not for me. That's not for diabetic heart patients.
The room inside is not for you?
No.
Why not?
Well, because I have spinal cord injury.
So you do have an exercise room inside that you can use?
Yes.
No. Well, there's one here, but not for us. So, I mean, it's just not something for a heart diabetic patient. Mm-hmm. With spinal cord injuries, it's just not something.
Yes.
There's not the equipment there for someone like that.
Yes. So, but there is a room if people want to go in there and do some stretching or whatever.
Yeah.
There is room. Okay. What about outside?
Nothing.
What can you do outside?
Outside
in this beautiful, beautiful day that we have today?
Oh, yes. Just come out and sit.
Yeah, come out and sit.
Just sit.
Mm-hmm. Is there any place to walk out here?
Well, yes and no, because the sidewalks, you can see they're evidently not safe enough. They're not.
Okay. What do you have in terms of sidewalks here?
I don't know. What would you say? Sidewalks around the building, but you got to be careful.
Why do you have to be careful with the sidewalk around the building?
People.
Mm-hmm.
Certain people.
Yeah, people come and wait to you and ask for money.
A little louder, Francisco, so we can hear you.
People come wait to people and ask for money.
Oh, they might ask you for money.
They might ask for cigarettes or money.
Or might ask you for cigarettes.
Or food.
They want to go in.
Or they want to go in. They want to know if you can let them in. It's like you have to tell them no.
Okay. So if you wanted to get some good exercise for your diabetes, you can walk on the sidewalk that surrounds the building, and that's it looks like to me.
That's it.
Yes.
There, everything else is parking and parking. For street traffic.
Yeah. There's a lot of parking here. Both sides. All sides of the building. It's all parking.
All parking.
And then you have to be careful of that, too.
Why?
See,
they'll back right into you.
Yeah, because you can
they
see
go flying around
they
here.
They put a stop sign.
Yeah, they just now put stop signs in.
The people, they used to stop. They used to turn the corners.
But they don't even stop
come
now.
Come flying real fast.
They go fast through here.
Yeah, real fast through
oh,
here.
Oh, yeah. It's like they race through here.
Mm-hmm.
But even with the stop signs, they don't even stop.
Mm-hmm.
We watch them on the other side coming in the morning.
That's new. That just put
and they'll just come right on through the stop sign, drop people off, and just jet right on through.
Really, learning, you know.
Mm-hmm.
They're just learning those signs are there, but mm-hmm. still, it's a stop sign. Mm-hmm. And like I always say, do they not see it? It's a stop sign.
Mm-hmm.
They just go right on through it.
Yeah.
They act like it's not even there.
But it's dangerous because a person could get hit, children could get hit.
Children could get hit.
Oh,
people
could
get hit.
From a vehicle, you know.
Yes.
Coming fast.
From the vehicles coming through here so fast. that sometimes you don't even want to be out here. Like the other night when they had the parties here, these vehicles were jetting through here, and oh my God, it was like, wow.
Just looking for a spot.
They were jetting through here trying to find parking spots, and the other side was so full. They came to this side. This side's full. So then you have the other places around here, they start parking. Remember, they were parking over in the college parking because it was so full over here.
Yeah.
How often is that a problem, lack of parking places here?
Every weekend.
Yeah, during the week is for the people who work here or come here to be seen. And the weekends is when Brandeis had their parties. Yeah. When Brandeis had their parties, they get really rush, you know, in traffic.
Yes. So people need to really watch their children, don't they, outside the building, especially on the weekend when the ballrooms upstairs are being rented.
Right.
Yes. Now I'm going to take this camera real quickly and swing it over to the children's playground, and then I'm going to ask you another question or two. So we're looking at the north side of the building, the historic Omaha Livestock Exchange Building. And we can see a little bit of the playground here where the children can go. And there's a swing set there. Now, I'm going to bring the camera back to you. In addition to that playground, what else is there for the children outside? Where else can they play outside?
Nothing else. There's that.
Nowhere. That's
just
it.
That's it.
But you got teenage kids in here, and the teenage kids have nowhere to go. Teenagers don't have anything to do in here, and there's a lot of teenagers in here, and they have nothing to do, nowhere to go. And that playset is not for a teenager. That playset is for children under 10.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And there's nothing for them to do, nowhere to go.
So I understand there are around 50 children living in this building, and around 200 adults who rent, 200 people altogether who rent these apartments around, because that shifts from week to week.
If not more.
Okay. So if the children only have this little playground outside, what do they do for fun?
They like to play football inside in the front hallway. And they like to throw the football at the elevator just to see how they can hit it and how many times, or basketball, or
play
what else?
Bicycles.
Bicycles down here. You name it, they've got it down here.
So where did they ride their bicycles?
Down here in the lobby.
In the lobby?
Yeah, in the lobby, front lobby.
Well, can't they bring their bicycles outside?
They could, but there's rules. They can't have skateboards or bicycles running around out here due to the fact that there's rules.
Yeah.
And they got to follow the rules.
Well, plus there's hardly any place for them
to
ride the bicycles out here. And if they rode in the street areas which surround this building, it could be dangerous.
Mm-hmm. And it could be very dangerous.
Yeah.
And down on that street down there, there's a sidewalk, but it's still dangerous.
Yeah, along the street.
Yeah, along the street. I mean, what if one of them falls? They go right into the street. They could get killed.
Yes.